Hi everyone, hope all is well. In today's video, we will cover request from Sunil Tiwari. So here is the requirement. Here is the link I would like to scrape for data analysis. And Sunil Tiwari is interested in these fields. So let me close this. I already opened the link here. And Sunil Tiwari requirements, he needs this name, then prototyping software, then buy. So these are the two fields, and one three, and this one the description is four field. For all of these products, which is 70k plus. So you can see here it is showing see more. Whenever we see a web page having this button see more result, when we click on it, it uploads new products or records. So in this case, normally JavaScript involved, so there are 50% chances that these websites have hidden API and find it, then we can get it easily instead of sending normal request like we are doing in Selenium. So it's not efficient method to scrape all of these because these are in large numbers. So for this we have to first check that it is API. If it's, then it will be great. So yes, it is. So let me explain the method how we will find the hidden API for web pages having see more button or more result, or like on scrolling it's upload new products like in Facebook and Instagram. So for this we have to open network tab. So I am pressing F12 from the keyboard. After pressing F12, you will see like this window. Let me clear this by clicking this clear. Now I am, let me clear again it so it looks full empty. Now I am pressing this see more button, so you can see here search result. I am clicking on this. So you can see here, this is the requested URL by pressing the see more button, and it has a request method get, payload is 20, and in response we are receiving HTML, and we are interested in this. So it's mean it has API. So we are now using this API to get all of these products. So to test this API, there are a lot of free tools available, but the most one is Postman and Insomnia. So you can use the one you know about it, both desktop and online version are available, so you can download it from here and test the API. So I already test, so that's why I am just sharing the logic to save the time. So here you can see the payload and the preview. Preview is the response after sending request to this URL. So now let's move toward the code section. So here you can see I import request and then beautiful Sue for getting data from this preview HTML. So here you can see URL is this one, headers this, the start. You can see when I click payload, so it's come in query string parameter. So we have to remove this start from the URL. this one. So the URL is only till before the question mark. This is the query string we are sending. And then here, request headers. So you can see there are a lot of arguments, cookie, which is very important for this. Without cookie, it will return empty result. So I already, you can see here, headers, cookie, accept encoding, user agent, etc. You can see here, I put here start is equal to 0. So 0 is for first page, and this page is showing 10 result per page. When we click see more, it load 10 more. Then again, when we press, then it loads 10 more. So we will increment this by 10 for getting for further results from the page. For now, I just sharing the logic. So you can see here, this is the URL, this is the query string, this is the header, and this is the response. So request.request gets URL, headers, and parameters query string. And for now, I just extract the products HTML select div.products. You can see here, I save the response in test.txt. So you can see here, inside this one class product serp card contents has h3 tag, h4, and then product serp card description. So we are interested in this, so I already target this one h3 inside this for name. So you can see here div product serp card, then inside h3, 0 is for index, so it will select the first one inside each serp card content. So now let me run the code, so you will see it will print all of 10 products name. Now you can see here, now let me clear it. For getting the other requirements, Sunil shared that he needs this one also, this and this. So let's write the beautiful swoop select. So let me duplicate it by Alt Shift down 4 times. And here you can see here, this one done. So now H4, inside H4, you can see here. This one, Figma. Like this, you can see here by, and then Figma. So let's target H4 for the second and third field. This one, this is will be the second, and after by will be the third field. So replace it by H4 and remove this one. So, and for getting the description, so here is the A tag which has a class this. So we have to copy this, Control C, and here we have to remove this, and here A dot is. So now let me run it again. You can see here by prototyping software by Figma. So here it did you call find all when you meant call find. So let me again it to index 0 to avoid this. Now you can see here we get it successfully Figma, then prototyping software by Figma, and here is the description. So now let me make it more pretty. So here I will declare the list like product list And then here, instead of printing, let me assign it name. Remove this. Here we can assign it the name like company. You can assign it whatever you want. And then here description. So now we will create here schema for pretty look. Schema will be like this. Name, key and value is name, then company, then the value is company, at the end description. And assign to description, and we will append each record schema in list. We declare here at top product list dot append, then scheme. So now I am printing each product schema here, and you can send the list after getting all of products. To save it in CSV or sending to a remote database or JSON file or whatever. So now you can see we got a schema for each record, name, company and description. Now it's time to get products from further pages, so we have to make changes in this code. So let me it. So interested on top 10 pages, you can increase or decrease it according to your requirements, but for demo now I just interested in top 10 pages. So let me apply loop here for I in range 1 to 11. So this will execute this code for 10 times. Let me intend it now. So here is, so first time query string will be 0, so it will print out. So here at the bottom, let me increment query string by 10 on each iteration. So start plus is equal to 10. So after this loop execute 10 times, here at bottom we will print total codes are then L length of product list. So now I am running it again. So now you can see here total records are 100, so we successfully get top 10 pages records. If you have any query, kindly share it. I will be happy to make video on it for you. Thanks for watching the video.